Let me give you a quick and dirty definition. Hypergamy is the preference on the part of women to choose male partners of equal or greater status. This is a preference in women that is as universal across cultures as the human tendency to smile when happy and frown when angry. Not only this, it's also universal in other species, both monogamous and tournament. Now, I don't know anyone in the men's movement who thinks hypergamy is, in and of itself, a bad thing, given the caloric investment and biological risks of pregnancy, childbirth, and lactation, and the decrease in productivity that accompanies them. It makes perfect biological sense that women would seek male partners who can compensate for those risks and costs. But here's the thing. Hypergamy becomes a more pronounced tendency in women the higher up a woman is in the social hierarchy. While feminists always assumed that women were forced into marriage and economic dependence on men, and that liberating women from that economic dependence would also liberate men from being breadwinners, this hasn't happened, and it isn't happening. Plainly put, a millionaire man will happily financially support a wife who doesn't work, but a millionaire woman will not do the same for a spouse. At the same time, she'll demand he be able to participate in the lifestyle she enjoys, which means he has to earn at least as much as she does. A male doctor will marry a female doctor or a female nurse. A female doctor will not consider for marriage a man who is not of equal or higher status than she is. She will not marry a male nurse or a plumber or an electrician or, heaven forfend, a house husband. Yes, there are outliers and exceptions, but they're few and far between.